Welcome back to our city hall. We don't go waste time because of say, you get the way when we say technology they behave and time go come begin they go. But we could just go straight into our discussion. Una they watch us Monday to Friday, so una know our names already. Unless Unkubi name don't change his name, now stay Unkubi. But two of us know they're important today. Now Nigerians and the matter will carry come. Now they very, very important. And the person when we say go chook mouth inside the discussion. In a person when we say be lawyer. He can look, say, all the book when he read as they consign lawyer work. He no go just stop out for inside court. He go come out to the chook mouth for issue when they affect everybody inside Nigeria. And he go they talk him based on the important lessons what we learn. We there inside the studio with Oga OJ Akinwale. Welcome to our city hut.
Ah, it's a pleasure. I'm very happy to be here today.
If those you wear white inside now, but we like in our court.
I know because we do.
But we know the lawyer una like trouble. Now anyway, we fight today. Now una de go. But we happy as you don't join us for studio and to discuss matter when we say it concern everybody inside Obodo Nigeria and talk the matter well. Now why we go just go straight into our first story? But we get culture with a shake hand, make it no be like say with a quarter when we come they ask. The question.
Good evening.
You're
welcome. Strong. Maybe we just go straight into our first story. And our first story got to do with the talk when we say the wife of Oga Presido, Mrs. Aisha Buhari, don't come out, can't talk. If now Ibobu Deuto say she raised alarm, waiting for this alarm. Not be say this one happened, but I won't paint the picture so that everybody go understand. Those when they live for near Aso Rock, that is the neighbors of Oga Presido. They said they mean they hear help. They say who they shout? Who just they shout help? They can't discover saying that the wife of Oga Presido, Mrs. Aisha Buhari, they can't call and say, what's up? Why they shout? She said, no, be say her husband never work well, that is Oga Presido. Saying don't do the one when be saying if he do. But if for do more, if not be the handwork of two people, who be these two people? She not talk anybody name. What thing that they do? She just talk, say, the badness when these people, they do, based on their own work. Say, the thing be like, say, I go speak big English. In a short circuit, the work of Oga Presido. Say, the good way Nigerians, they see today. If to say these two people, they no chook badness inside, Nigerians for see more. Please, people go come and go, they talk, say, wait, oh. On election day, if people come out to vote for their preferred candidates, then they vote for that candidate because they believe, say, that candidate get a better plan and love for the people. And the passion when the candidate gets, now you go make him do the work, when go make everybody better sweet for the country. Why we go in the year, say, some people, then they put hand. Some people can't go back to, since we returned to democratic rule for 1999, they say, we they get president. It be like, say, all our president, they good, but something, they cause problem. They say, during the days of Olusegun Obasanjo, they say, now good man, but somehow, because of saying they hear some people, now make them they behave somehow. The late Umar Musaya Abdua, they say he be good man, but una go remember that time they talk about cabal. The former president, Goodluck Ebele Jonathan too, they say he said be good man, but he be like say some people. Why he be say would they get president? When be good man, but he be like say, what he be the, he be like say when they say that matter? How Nigerians go take fear and sure say, bad people, they don't go spoil the work of good people, whether president, whether governor, anybody when they for inside government. Now, waiting barrister OJ Akinwale, go use the mouth, answer all of us. No gonna put here for grant. Now, our first story based on Acide Hall.
And our second story got to do with issues with the IG of police, that is the Inspector General of Police and the Senate. As IG don't come and talk, say, I no agree to this thing when I want to. I want to be this particular thing where they cry out for, say, no go agree. And now, the proposal we go give. Give National Assembly license to do it to approve and confirm every IG, that is Inspector General of Police, before they appoint them. That is, if Oga Presido talks to Luko, see my IG, see the person I want put as Inspector General of Police. At least he go through the National Assembly. National Assembly goes, okay, make you test, make you check whether you really, really fit for this responsibility. And they also get try to confirm them or not to confirm them. The IG don't come and talk, say, this thing no go work at all. Or to say, the matter go they politicize the bit, say, because if they give National Assembly that license, that's not a if they use their influence. They decide what they want and what they don't want and all that. And then after that's why I can't come across the crowd so heavily, say this one not go work. So not go allow them to do their own job well. But if also they look the amendment with the National Assembly, the carrier, we got to do with police matter. At least an amendment will say we're going to ensure efficiency. We're going to also ensure accountability. We're going to ensure respect and respect for human rights as well. That is what National Assembly ought to say. So this is the process we're going to need to do it in go through, so I will make sure say at least any IG when they come in, you go go through us, we go approve them before they do it. Before Oga President could say yes, carry on. You have been given the certification to do it to carry on with your work. Now second story be that.
He got one particular time when we said that they use inside the Obodo Nigeria. Anytime they call out, people go begin their talk. Different talk that we don't hear. That term now corruption. And if you check since Nigeria returned to democratic rule, we don't try put things when we say we're going to use fight this corruption. One, now the EFCC. Another, now the ICPC. Now the ICPC don't come at court talk say, if you check the way when we say Nigeria day, and you check the mentality of plenty of people inside the border of Nigeria, especially those when we say they're going to live for the future of this country. Say if you want fight corruption, to come out corruption for Nigeria, and you not involve those people, it is a waste of time. They say if you check the way when we say that they count people for this country, they can't use mathematics, calculator by percentage to check the people who plenty pass. They say now young people, now plenty pass for this country. In fact, they say around 110 million people, they'll be 35 years and below for a population of people, they talk say 200 million. Now, if these people are 35 years and below, what will be the thinking of those people? Some people don't come and talk say the people will fall under this age bracket, plenty of them. If you never pop champagne, you not be big boy. If you know they drive big motor, you not be big boy. If you know they live for estates where we say people know they enter anyhow, you not be big boy. If babes not surround you and guys when wear gold, diamond for body, you not be big boy. They say we need to tackle this monster. They call a monster. We need to tackle this monster so that the mind of young people go be one when we say person must work hard to get money. Person when get money must do well. Person when the government not be to. And the person go do for inside government. The ICPC come back and say, any campaign, say we fight corruption, we won't keep corruption, and you know involve young people, it just be like, say, you they go for Atlantic Ocean, another bridge, went past Atlantic Ocean, terminal bridge, you they fetch water there with spoon, come go the pour inside basket, they say, now you go tire. The water no go finish, the basket no go ever full. So if indeed we won't fight corruption, make we involve plenty young people. Oga Oje go answer that question. Whether we go carry Koboko, begin to flog young people, tell them, say, now nah, this way we go fight corruption, though. Now nah, that way we go fight corruption, though. Or we tell young people, say, the people when don't day ahead of them, when don't chop money, make them not look the example when those ones set. Then, what will be the good example where young people go look? Ingo talk. Now, our third story based on acid hurt.
And our final story, another report card don't come out, so, and hope the people will release this report card. Now, Global Terrorism Index, as the report card don't place Nigeria as the third most terrorized country for the fourth and consecutive time, that is, four times in a row for this year. And then going by what they talk, say, look, say, looking at the recent activities of headsmen, and then also the activities of Boko Haram, say that is why Nigeria still find themselves for this same position of fault as the fourth terrorized them this thing country for the entire world. They can also go for the talk, say, look, so in as much as they see this particular position, say Nigeria say they improved, say there has been an improvement somehow. Say compared to 2014, we say the matter be day very, very, very bad. It is bad. Say right now, but say we don't reduce that. But the reduction will even reduce the same. The position will still there. It's still very, very disturbing. And that's why this report card don't come out. And it is also like for our own authorities, our own government to also do it, to step up on their responsibilities to make sure, say, this report card, in as much as they place us for fault, when we say some people go talk, say it is a good position. But now good position, now position will be on the negative side, because not the kind of position we want at all. We don't want that. We don't even want to make our name today for the list at all. So for this reason, make our guards where they in charge. Security personnel, our guard president, and everybody where they involved, may they do it. May they also further step up on their responsibility to make sure say Nigeria come out from this particular position. May they not even see them at all. Now, our fourth story be that.
We don't hear the fourth story is when we say we can't come. And we now go see, say, I won't go get a visitor. Or go, oh, Jackie, well, let me just sit down. In the digest all the thing. In just the soak him in. Time don't reach for them to unleash. We now go hear word today. Barrister OJ, once again, welcome to Acid Hot.
Yes, a pleasure being here.
We could not waste time. We could just go straight into the matter. And make we start with a very, very important one. Because people, they look, say, government, now say people carry their trust, give, say, oh, yeah, work for us. But if we come, be say, story come, they come and say, he gets some people, when they inside government, so when no, they make us, they work for us, so that now if you trust us, well, how that matter take be? And if you check Nigeria since 1999, will they get good people? Will they get bad people? I won't ask you. Is it possible to come out bad people, bata for government. Why and how?
Well, to start with, because that statement means three things. The first thing may be that the person is weak, that he can't control his house. Secondly, it means that the politics is very complicated in Nigeria. And thirdly, it also means that somebody is trying to throw the blame of non-performance very well to another person. Now, if you take it that way, we see that this statement made credited to the first lady, if it is like that, it shows that this is not the first time the first lady will come out.
We'll come and talk,
and this is not the first time we hear this kind of thing. It shows that in order to just, sometimes I'm looking at it that it's a way to tell us that we are not sure of what we are doing. Because if you are in charge, if two people are disturbing, look at how millions of Nigerians, about 200 estimated. So two persons is disturbing us. It's easier to remove those two persons. Unless those two people are controlling, especially when people are afraid to lose their position. If you are doing it for posterity, even the first lady should even be bold enough to be patriotic enough to mention that two person. And if you mention the two person, all of us will know that two people, they cannot be greater than all of us in Nigeria. When we know them, it's you that is doing this. It may be somebody people will respect. And immediately we will know who they are. And again, we withdraw from them. Because if we don't know them, they are controlling people. That means they have a lot of people behind them. That's the reason the president cannot do anything about them. But if you tell them and the follower knows them, that this is what you are doing. Because the time we are talking about Kaba, we did not mention those Kaba. They are growing more. And this is language that is going on and on and on. The day we come out and mention those people. So in the day we are now saying, there are some people, you are not making a statement. You are just making, you are not talking.
Ogaoji, make I ask you. If we look this particular matter, we will not talk to the first time the wife of Oga Presu, they come and can't talk this kind of thing. We don't also talk, say, at least it don't happen serially, where we say she don't come out. They whisper, say, it is all is not well in the system. Okay, make we also go and look the fact, say, Oga Presu, they carry the flag of APC in what he contest. And concerning the fact, say, okay, we don't see this particular warning signal being given out to Nigeria, say, CRCBO. She, Oga President, on his own side, no go also feel, say, look, oh, enough is enough. Make him reposition himself by probably taking some kind of direction or some kind policies. We go do it. We go reposition in stand so that at least we go know, Nigeria will know, say, yeah, so through this rumor, about this particular talk where the first lady talk, no be, say, Nahinde in charge. So that make nobody say, you go just, you know, they lose control totally for the whole matter.
I believe at this time the president should consult the first lady. Who are these two people?
But Oga Presu
supposed to know now. He may not know. Ask. You know, women knows how to see where you cannot see. And said, who are these two people you mentioned? Mention them and you can investigate and see that, okay, because we are going at a particular time that Nigeria will decide. But if it's showing that we have given power to somebody, and he's the only person because there is a trust. That's the reason they voted for him. They did not vote for those two people. They did not vote for a minister. They voted for the president. And now if the president cannot control, he's telling us a signal that we should be careful. And the first lady cannot tell Oga President, let's go home. And people are saying, you continue. So if you look at it, people can use that opportunity to tell the president, get rid of these two people, or we tell you to go home, and we too ourselves will get rid of two people. If the president did not get rid of two people, these two people, I believe Nigeria should be able to get rid of everybody. Because if you get rid of the president, you get rid of the two people. But I believe if the president can, we still have time to correct things. If Nigeria enjoy Christmas, enjoy January, enjoy February, I think we know that, yes, the promise, if we go now, we are going to get the dividend. But if we have this problem now, we should
be very careful.
We
have to make ask this question. We got some issues where we say we'll go face for Nigeria. Everybody go talk, say, leave her, we'll manage. Now, Nigeria problem, for example, Instead of we come out truck when they for on top of bridge and road, we leave and there say, come out for your house early, in case the truck they hold up there, you know. Rather than we say we do the right thing. Now, as Nigerians, like some people they talk say, ah, before you enter inside politics, you must have some kind of big people. If you don't know, those big people, if they don't give you their support, you know, if you enter, and so our own arrangements there. You think say it's possible, say, if they talk say now the people get power, and power they the hand of the people truly and truly go fit take control, and what it be those things when the people go do, when go make people understand, say, even though we get president when we vote for and we respect and we love him, in office, they small to our own office, the office of the people. Because that we vote out, put for power. It is ever possible for this country.
Yes, it is possible. Everything lies on our hand. Until when we now take the position, say everything day, the power day on our hand. Because if somebody is saying, some people are jacking me, I cannot work because of this, we should start thinking and see that that person seems is not as strong as we believe he is. We start looking for alternative. The day we start doing that, that's the time everybody will sit tight. But when you know somebody will put you there, I'm telling you it has happened in my area before. This person was doing very well. The party decided to give it to somebody who have dealt with us in one small office. They put him. And they won't put him push because they have these people behind him. But at the end of the day, people in that area, because they are well enlightened, it's not just area down. They voted. He went to a small party. They voted for him. He won. He won all the big party, and he won very well. That is the power of the people. But they make us believe, say, we can't do anything, because if we do it, they will rig it. No, do it. We will get the result. Let us see, say, this person, even in our area, we know, say, no be good person, but they put him out because now the Baba put him. No, we are to decide. The Baba can decide who come from his side, but he cannot decide who come from all of our side.
Yes.
So that is what we should be doing. That if A, bring people because I don't want this one, I don't like this face, you come, I'm behind you, we will sponsor you. Then we people know, say, this person no go do things well. Let us go to his next neighbor, where we know, say, if he do, but he no get that support. If we people, because at the end of the day, not be these people, not be this big man, not be this Kaba that we vote. Yes. They have only one vote.
Exactly.
And all of us, we have, when we vote, the way we did in that area, we voted for him. With unknown party, even he cannot campaign, they go beat him up. But we started campaigning for him. I don't know him, we started campaigning because we know he's a good man. He won, and we are still enjoying the benefit in that area to today. That's the same thing I want us to do as Nigeria. Now let us look at this person. How is this man in this area? And we know him. But because those who we follow, don't just follow people. Follow the right thing. Our future, our children's future, they for our hand. If we fail to decide today, we will fail to achieve the greater things.
Oga Oje, you don't talk of the future and the future of our children. Now, why go on, we could discuss this ICPC and the fight against corruption. We know, say, our president don't talk and say, if we don't kill corruption, corruption will kill us. Make we talk with him talk when we enter for 2015. And I remember, say, the first military coup d'etat for this country for 1966. Now, because of, say, they say, corruption. And exactly. Politicians don't chop money.
Yes.
1966 problem, 2015 problem, 2019 problem. And the case when we can't get now, in a case of say, what is going to happen for the future? Because if you like say, the children of these days and those who go live for the future, them, the way when they look success, not be about people.
Exactly.
If you know they pop bottle, if you know they pop champagne.
Exactly. You're not there for the right step.
You're not successful. And people, they get rich by any means. How we go take fee involve young people? You think, say, for people when don't reach, for example, like Unku be their age, they don't already, they hopeless.
No, primary school.
I know you are a youth. That's what I'm saying. People when don't reach youth, like you now, in our situation, we can't change.
No,
you know when they open your eye like
this. No,
this is your capital, you feel like money
don't
inside.
Don't say that.
Now, Barista Oje, make we leave the Unku be now, say, this, their set, it don't finish. But we go back to our primary school now. Go begin to teach them. Or can we redeem our own?
Do I need any redemption?
You see, you are not even sure. So you are corrupt.
So let's look at it. When they're saying they are fighting corruption, I look at them that if you look at it holistically, you go, no, say, no be corruption that they fight. Really, if you see corruption now, as if this person who belong to me, I go waiting you do, I go bring them out. Mm-hmm. Those who belong to me, I no go do that. That's the thing, the sign they are showing us. I will start from here. Because if you see corruption, you said you are fighting corruption. And corruption, you are looking at the top, the governor, the minister. What about permanent secretary? Mm-hmm. What about people in the office? Mm-hmm. What about people at the gate? Mm-hmm. You are not looking at that. This is the thing has gone bad. Because somebody will not get anything before. He don't become governor. The next thing, he don't get house, Banana Island, he get for London.
Overnight.
He started having this thing and that thing overnight. Mm-hmm. Wait till they tell youth. So that is the thing. That you cannot just blame youth. It's whatever you sow, you will reap. Mm-hmm. It's the reaction that is we're having now. Mm-hmm. Because they know, say, these people are just getting it. They too are doing it in their own way. Mm-hmm. The elders are doing it in their own way. But that's the reason we have to go to the root. Instill this thing from beginning, from those young ones, and let us see patriotism, and see that you want to write your name in gold pen, yes, not having gold in your house. That is the thing. But now everybody want to have gold, but they have bad name. They don't care. Mm-hmm. What is the name? Mm-hmm. When you have house, you have private jet. Whether the name spoil, waiting you check get from the name. But when you go somewhere, and people before, when we were very small, they go say, your father is a good man. No, open the door. You too, you must be a good father. Yes. You must be like your father. Okay, let's give you a try. You know, before now, it's money. When you throw money around, you are already there. So that is the thing that is affecting the youth. Mm-hmm. And to fight corruption, I say, they were right. You have to go to the basis. Yes. Don't look at the guy alone, governor, minister. What about those even clerical staff? You go somewhere, they go say, if you don't bring money, your file go there somewhere. Mm-hmm. Corruption is that one. When they grow to become up there, then they know how to steal it bigger. So that is the reason we have to start to involve the youth, instill that. But one thing, if you said involve the youth, you are telling the children, like, let me give you a story. Somebody say they go to crab, went to mouse house. You see mouse, they jump. He now get home and told the children, when I go to this mouse house, the children, they are very smart. So you too, I want you to be smart. The children say, okay, daddy walk. He started walking backward. That's crab. That's the way it works. So if the elders are walking like crab behind, they are doing corruption, what do you expect? That is, what you are doing, when you are doing it,
what you preach.
You
exactly.
Preach, do it. Let us see that this government, we are going to do it. I will come here, I come with a Nizam patrol. Now I go with a private jet. Where do you get the money? How exactly. much is the salary? That's the thing. Then the youth too will look for a way, and their own will be smarter and badder and baddest.
Language. Looking at this very strong statement, where ICPC themselves, and ICPC now at least a body way government form on their own. So, okay, make now this thing. Looking at this particular strong statement where ICPC don't really say, get the youth involved. Which kind at least 10 step you go expect me government ABC the fee say youth are useless, youth are not relevant, they are the futures of tomorrow. Even when they're old, they are still the futures of tomorrow. Which kind of leg you go expect me government take right now? So that they go feel redeem their own image and also redeem the image of the waiting of the future generations when they come. Because if they're not carry start now to the drum, when it is going to be the appropriate time for our leaders, the current people, to do it and to carry the first
step. I say that when ICPC, where they help government fight this thing, don't see this thing, they've seen the frustration in their operation. They are not getting the result. They discover that, no, we have to go behind. Even if we start now, these people are waiting. Somebody say, if I get to that place, I too go chop anyhow. Because those who are in the front chop very well.
But
that is what the trend that will be going. The little children, I ask one, what do you want to be in future? He said, I want to be a politician. Why? Because I will chop money. I said, you are not even thinking about how you be help the nation. You solve electricity problem. You come with technology that will move the nation. Said, no, that one is doesn't going to work. All my uncle will study, waiting happen. Me, I want to be politician. I will start from now, no school. I said, I will go to school of politics. He don't know, but he's telling me something. So that is the reason we have to go. Let us start from secondary, from even primary school. Start instill. We have to instill that. But when we are instilling that, we are putting in the curriculum, we are teaching them. But what when we see those who are on top are doing the same thing? Let me tell you, that lecture finish from that place.
A waste of time.
It's a waste of time.
Okay, Oje, because they learn from outside. Make every Nigerian just hear him now say, the way when we say we they live our life, now the people when they come for back, then go watch, then go see. And I go notice me and Nkubi, they always the day here. They talk the truth
yes,
as they concern
yes.
Nigeria.
Would they, you say me and you, they talk the truth to concern Nigeria. And I responded, yes.
Why
yes.
When they say that yes, yes, like say you want they sure. So you know, sure, no, say no. They talk the
no,
truth.
No, they talk right from the bottom of my heart.
Give us the next story.
Yes, make no waste time. Make we also look this particular one because this one also gets to do with something we say. If we look at it don't raise a lot of argument about the independence of at least the police force and a couple of other things. Okay, the IG of police don't come out reject the proposal by the Senate and say, look, we know this now proposal we go give now the license to do it to appoint or probably approve to any appointment where Oga Prezo make. Say you know go work because of say if they give now the opportunity, now if you politicize them. But looking at this particular statement, I look at the fact, say, look, the police has been appointed by the president himself. She know also since say the role of this Senate stepping into it will further at least expand the responsibility and also make that police force a reliable to help people who get so much hope on.
Well, I know the IG has a reason. He said that looking from the background of the issue he has with the Senate. So it's quite understandable why he take that he took that position. But one thing is this: there is no system that will not work well if it is done properly. Even if it is the president and the police service commission that would do it, if they are putting somebody with credibility to be there, I see no reason it will not work. And if it's the Senate, they will do it very well. That say we do it like the way we have the interview of the ministers and to know who is capable or who is not capable and say we reject this person. If it is that way too, and it is for a purpose of scrutinizing and making sure that it's only the best person that will serve the interest of the Nigeria as a whole that will be there. I see no reason why anybody will say that is not going to. We cannot be doing conjecture in this area. So the two sides, to me, there is nothing if it is done properly. But if the president himself and the police service commission, that he himself is also the one appointing them and decided to politicize it, there will be politics there. So if the Senate too want to politicize it, that will be. But the only thing is that it's not enough to just make the rules. It is to abide by the rules. When we have credit, the system is credible, irrespective of the fact that they are not saying the Senate will be the one to appoint, to support, to suggest. They said it will be approved. But when they have contrary information and contrary things against the person, and they cannot throw it to him for him to defend himself. Because if they tell the president will say, continue. We know a lot of allegations made against the IG, and whether it's true or not, the president just did not, is not bothered by looking into it. But Senate will say, no, let's look into it. Let's investigate. And at the end of the day, say, this information is falsehood. Let us continue, do your job, we approve you. So I see no reason why. If it is to prepare check and balances, we know that is the system.
Very true. Oga Oje, we get Yakubu all the way from Taraba, Jalingo. Oga Yakubu, welcome to Asile Hot.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Yakubu. Oga Yakubu.
Honestly, I've been enjoying this your program, Asile Hot.
Thank you very much.
Good evening,
Good evening.
Yeah. My contribution about this corruption issue, honestly, you see, even this thing has been taken to the primary school or secondary school to teach students or put it into a curriculum for teaching there. They will not understand it. After all, these people at the top, they were still doing it. They say when they were to call the chief, the court, the younger one watched his mouth. So the younger one, they were watching the people up there. So whatsoever they've been teaching in the primary school, they will emulate from what people were doing up there. So as in the heart, I'm advising everything has to be started right from the top people there. Because corruption can never be taken all over. I mean, the, almost the entire population of the Nigeria, it can never contribute to that. So those people that chop the money first, they have to be cut out first from the above and come down to the lowest level. I think this is where it's supposed to be started. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much for this, your important contribution. You don't talk out. like waiting Oga OJ talk. We get Oga Tony Eze all the way from Benue State. Welcome to our city heart.
Good evening, Chukwudi.
We greet you, Oga Tony Eze.
Good evening, Oga Tony Eze.
Una well done, work.
Thank you.
I want to comment on the comment of President's wife.
Okay.
Let me tell you the truth. The truth of the matter is that if Buhari failed in Nigeria, there is no any excuse he will give us. Because I know how some of us suffered, keen on the line, doing so many things to see that we vote this man into power. And therefore, if the cabal in the Aso Rock is denying us the dividends that we're supposed to get from mm-hmm. democracy mm-hmm. through this man that we voted in, there is no excuse that he will give us. Mm. The only thing I know is that 2019 is coming, and most of Nigeria is getting enlightened and educating. Mm-hmm. If anybody have done well, we will vote him back. And if anybody has not done well, if INEC will be on our own side, we will give so many red cards to politicians that are blocking the success of Nigeria. We will seriously give red card to them if INEC will permit us to do so. Mm. Thank you and God bless you.
Oga Tony Eze, thank you very much for this, your important contribution. Now, what do they talk here? Say, every Nigerian supposed carry matter we consign us for this country on top of our head. Now, only that way, the small contribute, where they contribute, go make this our country better. INEC, they work for us. Everybody, now us, now in the here, just like we they hear Kenneth when they call us from Lagos. Kenneth, welcome to our city hearts.
Kenneth, good evening.
I got you, buddy.
We they hear you, Kenneth.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening. Reduce the volume of your television. Just they talk, they go. I beg, if you call us, just reduce the volume of your television so that we go fit hear you. You go fit hear yourself and hear us. And the full Nigeria will hear the talk when we say you the talk. Oga Uje, there's no way we go talk about this Oga police matter. We will not go talk about security and the report when they come out for inside this our country. They don't come out talk, say, back to back, meaning say,
back to back
as we did like this, the result what will they get? Mm. We never fail for this bad result. As they concern insecurity for inside this our country, Nigeria. I go like ask, because we don't invest money. Mm. Since 1999.
Now we still invest.
Since 1999, we carry money, say, okay, all this money now for security. Mm. But people see they look, say, the kind of security when we say they need, not be the one when we say we they see. Mm. Before I ask that question, as where the money they go, and how we go take track the money, Basi, they call us from Akwa Ibom, we will track up. Oga Basi, welcome to our city hut.
Good evening.
I greet you, Oga Basi.
Welcome, well done. My own contribution is that, you see, what that our man sitting down here was saying concerning corruption, he said the truth, because if you're looking at the APC, they are not fighting the right corruption. If you want to fight corruption, start from your home. Dealing from your home, when you finish from your home, then you go outside. I'm from Akwa Ibom State. Let the old Nigeria look at what happened in Akwa Ibom State. Our former governor is now jumping from PDP to APC. If they want to ask a question, what makes him to jump from PDP to APC? Let him say the truth.
But so Ogabasi,
APC are not fighting the corruption.
Ogabasi,
sir,
make I just also mention this one. Make it not be like say with the talk, go one side. You get people too when we say that they APC. Then come PDP. We get plenty of them. Like, for example, our Senate president today. Now, APC win election, but it not their PDP back. You not think, even though people, they look the matter like that, and now still the way when we say the breeze, they blow, and make them, they fight the corruption like that.
I hear you, my brother, but then, this is our own, there is something which the whole Nigeria know. Everybody know. We that before quite will say we know also. So thank you. That is my contribution.
Oga Basi, thank you very much for this, your important contribution. Look, we look this bad result when we get. This not be result when we say, person they go show in papa for house. Say, for when it come to insecurity, in the carry,
fought.
But the question now, say, the things where they cause this problem, the things don't remain consistent. But if you like say the idea when would they use to solve this problem? Now the same idea when we know they see results. Emmanuel from Lagos. Would they hear you, Oga Emmanuel?
Emmanuel, good evening.
Okay, Ima, you there? I beg, if you get chance, call us back. Barrister Ojina, you go answer that question.
Yes. When we see that about $1 billion was taken
$1 billion
to fight and create security, to fight insecurity in this country. And you know that money, a huge money. If I tell you in Naira,
about 300 or something billion.
That's what can be here. But the truth is this. If you look at the system adopted, even the president, I will still say it. This is my feeling, and this is what I know from the pulse of the people, that the president who contributed to this thing. When the Hausa Fula, the herdsmen, they started little trouble. That is the problem with Boko Haram. When they started it during Jonathan, they were supposed to stop it.
We will just take this little...
Madam Josephine, they call
let this call for Madam Josephine, because this one, if we don't take her now, the way that trouble take... Madam Josephine, first lady of us in the heart, would they hear you?
Good evening, sir.
Good evening, Madam Josephine.
Our Bonga visitor, good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I just want to say concerning our first lady. This is the second time she's saying it about Kaba. This is not the first time, this is the second time. So I think Nigerians should be wise. Now, all the exams that they repeat, why if you say you go repeat them again? For politics, they know they repeat. Once there's no forward, you go backward. So I don't know the kind of government you are running. 2 steps forward, 10 steps backward. Because I had a conversation with somebody yesterday. She was complaining that this president has done all this. I said, not doing well. They are all part of the system. Since it is something, they are being in the system. We should see changes. This is the third time he ran before he became president. I believe he had agenda. He had plans to come and do. If the wife is not saying that what two people are injuring the husband from doing what he should do, then let him leave. So that those that are ready to do it, with our own voters' card, with our PVC, we'll bring those people in. Then secondly, talking about security, let me tell you, my brother, the truth of the matter is, if these people are not well taken care of, fighting these insurgents will not go anywhere. Because the soldiers there are not really well taken care of. Let me just tell you the truth. I am in the system, we know what is happening. Soldiers are not being, their welfare is nothing to write about. Nothing. Thank you, and God bless you.
Thank you very much, Madam Josephine, for that solid contribution we don't make. And then bring back to your guy, Uji.
I will take it from...
We'll take this call back. We'll take this call back to
hello,
back.
Chukwode.
Emeka, Emeka, good evening.
Yes, Chukwode, Nkubi, good evening.
We greet you again, Emeka.
Yes, my brother, and I well done now.
Yeah,
my own theory is that the wife of the president will not be using all those things as an excuse. As far as I'm concerned, if this government has failed, they have failed. Not that they will use it and say that the cabal, in the cabal, who has the power? The president has the power to sack, to do everything in this country. They cannot use that one as excuse. And another story for Senate, as for the Senate, at least before the president will appoint Inspector General of Police, he must go through from the Senate before, not being in active capacity for 6 months. That's why you see when Senate president, the National Assembly invited the police 2 times. He refused to come because of the power of the president. So as for the Senate, thank you and God bless you,
thank
my brother.
Thank you very much again, Mika, and for your contribution as well. So going
yes,
back to you.
I will start from that welfare issue because I have soldiers that are very close to me at that Sambisa area. I have 2 captains. I've lost a lieutenant that's very close to me. And I know that those 2 captains, one of them, the husband happened to, the wife is a lawyer in my chamber. And I knew everything. It's firsthand. Whenever they're in Lagos, they're in my office telling me what is happening, trying to give them support. And that's what is pushing him, that people are supporting him independently, we that are very close to them. So if they tell you what is happening there, the kind of arms those people have, and what they are using, and other things. When the help will not come at the right time, the decision will not be made at the right time, I believe we have spent so much money that we believe that we should have. This insecurity is not only the Boko Haram issue. We know some areas you cannot go there, you'll be afraid that you can be kidnapped. Some areas you cannot dress well. Some areas you can go there, you cannot speak this Queen English. You have to speak the one you can have just stammer everything so that People will not see you as somebody they can kidnap and start asking for money. So we can see that the insecurity, and we see ritual killings. All those things is no easy. That's the reason when we are talking about the index. Index is not talking about we are fighting Boko Haram, we are almost winning. That is not enough. We are talking about people dying every day. We heard about in Zamfara how many police officers were killed.
Yeah.
Do you know what it means to kill one police officer? He said, now you are killing scores of army, scores of police officers. Let me tell you, over 6,592 military personnel within 11 months, we lost them. I have the full record. This is the record. Do you know who they have? Family? They have their family. They have their people. It is there. Somebody was telling me, soldiers signed to die. I said, at least we have a chance to even fight.
Yes.
You were not giving them a chance to fight. There is no strategy. There is nothing. So that's the reason we say that we should put the right people and not politicize security issue.
Thank
security
you.
Issue is
economic issue. Niger, let me call from Abdul Rafiu. Abdul Rafiu, welcome to Aside Hot.
Okay. Ogautu, good evening.
Good evening, Abdul Rafiu.
How are you? I want to contribute to this program.
Oh, yeah, feel free. Carry go.
Okay, okay. You know, I see that your man, that's your guest, is talking of saying corruption. All the APC, they are fighting PDP. You know, if we start something, we start from somewhere.
Okay, we hear you.
So if Tosema, they are doing for PDP, let them finish what they can do. We must start from somewhere. If they do partial, they do it for themselves. Another person will come later. Retaliate for the PDP. So we have to start from somewhere. Not matter of saying if something starts something, this one we say it's just they do it because of this. So we cannot move forward like that.
Abdul Rafiu, thank you very much.
That is my contribution.
Thank you very much for your distinct. We get Coach Joy. Coachy, good evening. Welcome to us.
Good evening. Good evening to you good people there. Very star, good evening.
Good evening.
You narrated everything about this corruption, the way the thing in my mind. I love the way you said it all. At least your listeners must have heard what you said. No need of me going into it again, because that corruption is the issue that is bothering this our country now. So me, as a woman, and for the wife of the president, Aisha Buhari, I feel that woman is outspoken and is a good woman. I think she has a good heart for might have coming out to tell the Nigerians what is happening inside there that we outside are not seeing, but they will not allow her to talk. I want to advise our president. He is in charge. Look, me as a coach, if I'm in the field, I have a team. I'm in charge of my team. Yes. Nobody should come and control my team for me,
exactly.
Okay? And my players should obey the rules and regulations of the game. If not that you're out, another person comes in, he should reshuffle his cabinet and throw away those people who are doing that then, doing those things they're doing there. If not, I will just believe that he is fighting his enemies, not fighting corruption holistically. Thank you and have a nice evening.
Thank you very much. We go just lock our telephone line now so that our Ogbonge visitor, Ogaoji Akiwale, go fit talk all the matter, make we really get understanding. Over to you, Oga.
Yes. As I said earlier, that issue of corruption is not only fighting at the top alone. And as somebody called, rightly said that, even you have to, charity begins at home. You are saying, okay, you start with some people. No, charity begins at home. If I can sweep my house very well, I'm telling you, if I started pointing hand to others, they will. And I want people for this country to move on. I want to advise those people that know that this wealth of this nation, they just kept it somewhere that is useless. Instead of it, surrender it to this nation. And let the government come with another policy. If you can bring, we can do some kind of plea bargaining. So that this money will be reinvested and reinjected into the economy. If not, those people, that is the reason they are saying Kaba, they will use that money to be fighting your government. And at the end of the day, somebody is saying, somebody will retaliate. We are teaching our children the system of retaliation instead of teaching ourselves the system of truthfulness. Yeah. So if you are cleaning your house, if I see you that you see me cleaning my house, you cannot just come into my house and be throwing dirty. I have dirty in my house, and I said I want to go and clean outside. It's uncalled for. That's the reason they can't have the sources. When you have the sources, you clean your house, you will not tolerate it. You are there, you are out. Next person will, because you are there. If this government fail, and that's the reason I was advising people that, it's not about who is the best person, who is the best person. What is happening is what we deal with. When you know that you allow those people to hijack your government, we will vote you out. You will tell them that, he said, I want to spend, I have agenda, I've not finished it, and I can only finish it within 8 years, and you want to stop me, I will let you go. When you know that people will just throw you out, you just said, ah, when I have good intention, your bad intention make me to lose my reputation. You will go home instead of me. So we will now, when you know you have good people, that's the best governance. And that's how they were doing in civilized nation. You are not doing well, the president will tell you, please, thank you, go. They pick another person, run them. When they know that minister, you will lose your portfolio if you are already doing the wrong thing. Mm-hmm. And you see people are queuing to do better things. And they are doing it, and they are doing it, we're having the result. I'm telling you, everybody coming there, we have that mind. But when you go, and even I want to advise us as Nigerians, stop going to politicians and say, ah, you're supposed to make enough money to be sharing with us. Mm-hmm. So we are encouraging that corruption. So when you go there, you want to share money. Where do you get this money? We start asking you questions.
Question, yeah.
Then he knows that that money, where are you? We are moving out. I've seen somebody who is in House of Assembly move away from that area. He's representing the area. He's living in another area elsewhere. He doesn't. He has sold that house. He doesn't have anything. But when the time of election comes, he come. He has rented the apartment. That place is not good enough for him. So we know that next person, this person is not closer to us. Let us vote the next person who is here with us. When we start doing that, people will know that we want you to, all of us cannot be in Aso Rock. All of us cannot be in the governor's house.
Yeah.
So we have surrendered this thing for you. Do this. We are not asking you to turn it to where you would now go and make so much money. But society, too, we're supposed to be part of it. That we are not demanding what is not necessary.
Oga Uje, you don't finish talk for this matter. What do you talk now? Say, people when the government get their work.
Yes.
We, when we did, when they lead, we get also our get own. Our work.
Yes.
If they do their work and we do our work, the country will make sense. If they know they do their work, now our business to make sure, say, we not carry work. People when we say not serious, enter government. And those when they must do our work. So in our relationship, when we say, as then they do, we they do, and our country and society they better. Oga Oje, you get this handshake.
Yes.
You try. You don't finish talking about this matter.
Thank
you. You won't even shake my hand. You don't even hold your hand. Take shake. Our people went there for hearts.
My brother.
Thank you very much. Yes. Hold on now. You won't hold on. Hold your hand. I beg my people, Jare, to come back tomorrow again with another beautiful edition of your program.
See, as you behave like a person who won't sleep already by 7:30.
You have a problem
with me. My people. To enjoy more of this our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.